Hello, beautiful people, and welcome. We're going to go over the module 18. I believe it's 18.1 and 18.2 for the IM3 quiz. Now, disclaimer, we are on campus, so if you hear a loud bell or the intercom goes off, I do apologize in advance. Also, I am human, so if I make a mistake, just let me know where the mistake occurs, so that way we both can learn from my mistake. Let's get started. There's a lot of key terms in this quiz. You need to know what those mean in order to know what it's asking. The first key term that it's asking is coterminal. Coterminal means that you start it on your initial ray. So if we have an angle, you start on the initial ray or the initial side, which is always on the positive x side. And then you end at the same spot. So you end on your terminal ray or your terminal side. Now, how many loop-de-loops you do in the middle doesn't really matter. Coterminal just means you start at the same spot side and you stop at the same side. So in this case, it's asking for a positive. So you need one positive and one negative coterminal angle. So again, where does negative 315 degrees? 350 degrees is about here-ish. And so we want something that is a positive. Oh, excuse me, I did that wrong. It's negative 350 degrees. So let me quickly erase that. Glad I caught that. Negative means you go the opposite direction. So it's going to be here. The distance traveled is the same. All you need is direction for negative. Okay, direction means you go clockwise for negative, counterclockwise for positive. Since it's negative, we're going to go clockwise. Okay, now the easiest way to find out what your coterminal angle is remember those loop-de-loops that I talked about, those rotations? Well, we're gonna use them rotations. So the first thing we need to do, we have negative 315. I'm going to add a full rotation to that. So I have negative 315 plus 360, and that's equal to 45. So one of my coterminal angles is 45 degrees. That means I start and I stop at the same rays. Now it's also asking for a negative coterminal. You cannot use the one that they already gave you. It's asking for a coterminal angle. If you give me the same thing, so some of you decided to give me negative 315, that is not a coterminal angle. That is the angle. So for a coterminal angle and you want it negative, I'm going to take negative 315 minus 360. Negative 315 minus 360, and that is negative 675 degrees. You must include degrees. If you do not put your unit of measure, in this case degrees, I'm going to assume they are radians and it would be considered incorrect. So you have two angles here. Question number two, find a coterminal angle between 0 and 360 degrees. Again, coterminal is another keyword or the same keyword. Coterminal angle means you begin at the initial ray and you end at the same terminal ray. Loop-de-loops don't matter, but in this case, they want the angle to be between 0 and 360. So in order to do that, I'm noticing I have a pretty large angle at 715 degrees. So in order to figure out a smaller angle, I'm actually going to subtract 360 degrees. I'm going to subtract one full rotation, and that gives me 355 degrees. Is 355 less than 360 and greater than 0? Yes, it is. So you are done. Convert each radian measure into degrees. So you know you are given a radian, you want degrees. So you are converting. So there is a conversion. So the way to do this is because you want degrees, degrees are going to go on top and radians are going to go in the bottom. So this is something you need to memorize. This is your conversion rate. And now here you are multiplying and you're dividing. So I'm going to get rid of my pi's. And I'm going to get rid of my 18. The 0 is left over. That means I have a 10 on top. So now I have negative 19 times 10. So that means I have negative 190. What do I have? Degrees. If you don't put your unit of measure, it will be marked wrong. It will be considered in radians. Convert each degree measure into radians. So now we're going the opposite direction. Given to us is degrees, we want radians. So now we want for our conversion to have pi on top since we want our answer in radians. So I'm going to cross out them zeros. 6 goes into 18 three times. So what is left over? This negative is left over, pi and 3. So I have negative pi thirds as my radians. Hello, beautiful people. Just chiming in here. Just want to let you know that for numbers 5 and 10, we're going to skip those for right now. And then I will post a link, should be somewhere on the screen right now, that you can click if you'd like to see those questions worked out. Again, I apologize. Go ahead and click the link if you'd like to see numbers 5 through 10. Thank you. We're almost done here. Find the reference angle. Reference angle, three things you need to know about a reference angle that is another keyword. Reference angle means acute, positive, x-axis. So that means it's the acute angle, which is less than 90 degrees. It is positive, and it's from your x-axis. So then, if we know this full half rotation is 180 degrees, and we have 120, what is this distance here? And this distance is 60 degrees. And then for number 12 is again saying, if I go one full rotation, so if I complete this, where would I be? Well, I'd be at 36 pi over 9. So that means I went one full rotation, another full rotation, I'd be at 36 pi. But I'm not. There is a little bit missing. So how much more do I need to travel to complete this full rotation? So I'm going to subtract 32 pi ninths from it. So that means I am 4 pi ninths short of completing that rotation. That means that this reference angle is 4 pi ninths. Now, for those of you who converted this into degrees, don't do that. It's asking for radians, so your answer must be in radians. If you put an answer of degrees when it's asking for radians, it will be marked incorrect. All right, now the extra credit question, I wasn't expecting you to solve this without a calculator. My only expectation for the extra credit is for the correct setup. Since we have a side, an angle, and a side, we need to use the law of cosine. Law of cosine says that if you have this angle between two sides, we're going to take the cosine of that angle, and I work my way backwards. So then I have cosine of 32 times 17 times 30 times 2 minus 30 squared plus 17 squared. And that's equal to this opposite side. In this case, we can call it BC, segment BC squared. As long as you gave me this, you got 1 point extra credit. All right, beautiful people, hopefully this clears up some misconceptions on your quiz. Remember, you are able to retake this. Hopefully you'll score much better than the first time around. If you are stuck on numbers 5 through 10, please come in for tutoring. I am always available. Just let me know when you are coming in so that way I can be in. Once again, thank you for watching, and hopefully you will do better on your retake. Take care.